Hi guys and welcome to Soft Hints, another video about pandas and how to map the headers to new column in data frame based on the values of these columns. You can see also some bonus things which you can learn from this video. As a dataset, we are going to use information from Stack Overflow surveys for 2018 because the one for 2019 is not released yet. You can download information as CSV and later read it with pandas. Before to start with demonstration, I wanted to share for the guys who don't want to watch the whole video or something like too long to watch, what is going to be the final result. We have a data frame with three columns: hobby, open source and student with values 1 and 0. Finally, we are going to produce a new column with the header for each column where we have one. As you can see here, we have a hobby with one, we have a hobby and open source, and here we don't have any value. So this is going to be done in two ways. The first way is by using npWhere. You can see the example here and use it from the link which I will post in the description below. And the second way is by using matrix multiplication. You can see the example here and we have exactly the same output as the other one. So let's start with the examples. So first we're going to import pandas and read the CSV file which is already downloaded on our machine. You can see how many rows do we have and how many columns. I wanted to mention also that for this CSV file we are using low memory equal to false in order to avoid warning from pandas, which is columns have mixed types, specify the type option on import or set low memory false, and this is going to optimize your data frame. So let's see some examples from this data frame. You can see that we have many columns with different data inside, but we are interested only in three of them. The first one is hobby, the next one is open source, and finally student. And let's create a new data frame only for these three columns. We are going to do this by reading only the three columns from the original data frame and assign this to new data frame, which name is DF Answers. You can see the first five examples here. And you can see that we have yes, no, and yes, part-time or some other values. So we want to map this to 1 and 0 instead to have yes and no in order to do some transformation of this data frame. First we can do this column by column. You can see how you can map for a single column all values to something else. You can use the data frame name, then the column with dot notation, and finally the method. You can provide a dictionary with values. In this case, we are converting yes to 1 and no to 0. So as you can see, we have zeros, but also a none. And this is because we have a value which is unexpected and we don't have it in this map here. And this will happen also if you have a none value for this column. That's why we need to get all unique values or all distinct values for this column, and this can be done by using the column name and method unique. In this array we have all values which are which occurred in this column. You can see that we have yes part-time, yes full-time and none. So now let's see how we can apply the same to all columns of a data frame and also how can you use a map and none with pandas and apply. So first we're going to import numpy as np in order to use npnone for our map. Then we're going to map everything else to 0 except 1, which is going to be mapped for yes. And finally we're using apply and lambda, which is going to be applied on each cell and we're applying all the new values that we have. As a final output, you can see that we'll have 1 for yes, and for everything else we'll have 0. So after this conversion, we can move to the first way how to convert the headers to a column. And we're going to use npWare, which is going to give us npArray with values for the columns. Let's execute this way and check what is the result. As you can see, we have hobby for the first one, hobby and source for the second, and 0 for this one. And how npArray is working, and npWare in particular, you can see that we have a one dimensional array here, and we're going to apply where. Where is going to return the indexes of this array where the condition is met. So we have index 4, 5, and 6. This condition is met for one dimensional array. And if you want to get the values of the original array, you can use give the results to the original array, and you will get the values where this condition is met. And now let's speak a bit about multidimensional or two-dimensional arrays and npWare. So you can see the original examples for the official documentation about npWare. And let's execute the example. You can see here we have true, false, true, and true. This is the two-dimensional array that we have, and this is the output, which maybe it's not expected for you and it's a bit complicated to be understand. So let's run two different examples and check the output, and this will help you to understand why we have 1 and 8, 3 and 4 from the first example. If you put all time for each of them false, you'll get all the numbers below. And if you have all the times true, you'll get all the numbers which are above. So in this way, you're switching which number to be taken from the two-dimensional array. As you can see, if you have false, you're going to take the second one. And if you have true, you're going to take the first one. Or at least this is some basic explanation how to understand this example. And let's move on the second way how to convert the headers to a column in pandas. This is going to be done with matrix multiplication. So we are going to create again a new column answer. We're going to do a matrix multiplication for the columns, and finally assign this value to the data frame. You can see the output here. And let's check how the matrix multiplication on or a dot method is working in pandas. Let's say that you have these two examples here and you want to do matrix multiplication. You're going to get this output. Maybe it's not clear for you, but let's change a bit the data and see again what is going to happen. So instead of 1, we will put 2 here. And instead of 1 here, we'll put 0. You can see for the output what we have. We have 2 and 8, and we have zeros here. And I hope that this is helping you to understand how the matrix multiplication is working. And finally, I wanted to say that in the next video, we are going to see some examples for a Stack Overflow. For example, let's say that we have languages, a column with languages, and we want to do some operations in order to get the same information as Stack Overflow for the most popular languages. And we will do this with several different steps. We are going to convert a list column to many columns. Finally, we are going to read these values and do some counts for them. So that's all for this video. If you have any questions about headers and how to convert them to columns, please ask in the comment section below. If you like the video, you can put a like, and also you can subscribe if you want to see more videos about pandas, automations and best practices in programming, also for Linux as well. So see you next time.